Hello everyone, this is Darth Snowvey here. I know it may be a little different what he's been seeing for the past few months, but the chairs were kind of cheap, so they kind of broke. So we're stuck to filming in these crappy angles until I get new ones. So yeah, enjoy. Now, this is my top 10, in my opinion, the best comic book movies I feel like that were ever made. Now, these are the movies I'm going to show you are the ones that resonate the most. These are the ones I actually own. Now, one of them I can't find at the moment, but my honorable mentions are Deadpool. As much as I enjoyed this film, I think there's better comic book movies that exist out there. And I do consider it probably one of the most overrated movies of this year. It's still fun, but I wouldn't qualify as top 10 comic book material. X-Men 2. As much as I enjoyed that film, I think there's far better comic book movies than X-Men 2, and I don't feel like it's really held up that well, in my honest opinion. Guardians of the Galaxy. I enjoy this movie, but again, there are far better movies than this. On the flip side, I'm also going to do the top 10 worst comic book movies. So you're going to see a lot more videos than usual tonight, because I might as well film all these at once. For the first one, X-Men Days of Futures Past, the Rogue Cut. This, if you're not familiar, is the extended cut of Days of Futures Past. It has scenes that were cut from the theatrical version and even alternate versions of the scenes that weren't in the original. I feel like this version is a stronger movie than the theatrical version, despite that version being good. If you haven't seen the theatrical cut, I would recommend you pick it up. I feel like it's better than the original cut, and I think it's the best X-Men film to date. Now, this is going to piss off Pedophile Express. Go fuck yourself, Andre. Die, you pedophile piece of shit. Avengers. What makes this movie so good? It built off about 5 years' worth of hype. Because this film was announced in 2007, as far as I remember, or 2008, that they were going to do Avengers. And a superhero crossover was something that hadn't been done at the time. It wasn't heard of. People didn't think it would ever be made. Because people made jokes about Justice League for years that that'll never be made into a movie. Well, they were saying the same about Avengers, but did they prove them wrong? 5 years of build-up, you know, from introducing these characters and having us actually see these characters together in the same movie for the first time ever on the big... I saw this in theaters. It was amazing. I loved this movie. One of the greatest comic book movies ever made. In my opinion, this is how to do a superhero movie when you take characters from various different comics and put them all together on the big screen for the first time. This is how it's done. Not do half-ass fucking first movie, a half-ass sequel, and a fucking worthless filler movie. And expect people to give a two shits when they see Aquaman, Flash, and Green Lantern, if he's assuming he's in the goddamn movie. That'll be a subject for another day, but that's just my point. Avengers did something that Justice League will not have. People will already have gotten familiar with these characters, so seeing them all together, especially if they're interested in one character and they want to see this movie because they're in it, they're going to want to... It's going to be an awesome experience either way. You'll see new characters you're not familiar with, but then again, it may have them check out the other stuff that they're in, like the other movies. Or if you've seen them all up to this point, you're a hardcore comic book fan and been waiting for your entire life to see all these characters on the big screen together for the first time. It was a great experience. Holy shit. That was probably one of the most memorable moments in movie history, was that scene where all the Avengers assemble in New York. Oh my god. Fuck you, Justice League, you'll never have that. And what started it all? Iron Man. This resonates with me very well because I feel like it started the Marvel MCU, and in my opinion, it started the renaissance that we're currently at with comic book movies. In my opinion, this is the best era for comic book movies. And I don't think this is a fucking thing I'm just fanboying over. It honestly is the best era for comic book movies. And I don't think we would not have the movies that we have now. And we would have the shitty DC Cinematic Universe had it not been for Iron Man 1. There's a lot about Iron Man 1 that people don't really give credit for. So it deserves to be one of the best movies. Now, in my opinion, what rejuvenated interest, and I reviewed all three of these movies. I'm just going to talk about one of them. Spider-Man 1. This movie here. I think it's the best Spider-Man movie to date. In my opinion, I don't think there's a Spider-Man movie that comes close to being as good as that one. In my opinion, it's the Superman 78 of Marvel movies. After Warner Brothers nearly killed comic book movies for good, Spider-Man helped bring it back. Yes, Blade and X-Men did it, but I feel like Spider-Man is when the resurgence was complete. And as a result, we got movies like Daredevil, which was shit. We got Fantastic Four, which was also shit. We got Elektra. We got to see comic book characters that we had not seen on the big screen. And it's not just the popular ones. And I don't believe even the MCU would have ever existed had it not been for the first Spider-Man. Now, I think this is better than anything that DC's ever put out in the past 20 years. Captain America's Civil War. It does something that most comic book adaptations don't do, is be better than the source material. I felt it was a good movie. I don't give a shit what any DC fanboy has to say. Captain America Civil War, I thought, was great. It was actually... I just can't describe how good that movie was. Just if you've seen what all these characters have gone through from the very beginning, you know, Steve Rogers and Tony Stark, seeing what all these characters have gone through from their first outings, and look at this point, their fight, you actually can feel something. There's actual tension. He almost dies. And this movie got something that Batman v Superman didn't do right. This movie was inspired by that piece of shit. Captain America Civil War was a good movie. It really is. Go fuck yourself, Andre Pedophile Express. It's the best comic book movie of the year. Until I've seen Doctor Strange, I consider it the best comic book movie of the year. Now, the next movie, some people may question if it's a comic book movie, but it is. It started off as a comic book, and it followed the comic well. Ninja Turtles 1. Ninja Turtles 1990. This movie here. The one on the very top. Now, why is this, on the number 5 spot? Well, it follows the comics, the original Mirage comics, well. It is the closest thing we've ever seen the comics brought to life. And the fight with the Shredder was an adaptation, which is almost spot on from issue 1. First fight with Raphael and Casey Jones. It follows the comics well. And I feel like it's one of the most underappreciated comic book movies. It follows the source material well, and it respects what came before. And it was different from the cartoon at the time. I consider that the Batman 89 of the Ninja Turtles franchise. And it's unfortunate that people don't see the turtles in that light, but I'll get to that when I talk about Ninja Turtles video. Now for the top four spot, Captain America Winter Soldier. I think, in my opinion, this is the best MCU movie to date. And for those of you who say, oh, but the MCU's movies are so cookie cutter, they're so forgettable, they're so predictable, this movie is actually more thought-provoking than any fucking shitty-ass DCU movie that's out. You're dealing with someone that is living in a world that is unfamiliar with them. It's alien. And I'm not going to really talk about the movie much, but there actually feel like there's actual tension in this movie. Yes, the MCU does have its flaws, but I feel like Captain America, with the Winter Soldier, felt different from your typical MCU movie. And fuck it. It's better than the Dark Knight trilogy. Eat shit, Nolanites. I thought it was a better movie. I feel like it's the best the MCU has to offer, and Captain America Civil War almost topped it, almost. But I still feel like it's the better movie. Because it's one of the few movies in the MCU that ends on a better, bittersweet note. Honestly. Now, for the top, this is, should be obvious. If these aren't in the top three, at least if you're talking about actual comic book movies, you're, in my opinion, you're wrong. Even though you're free to disagree with me, but in my opinion, you're wrong. Superman the movie. How can I not have this on the top 10? And I saw this again recently. I don't know why I haven't reviewed it yet. This basically is the father of comic book movies. Without Superman 78, you wouldn't have the comic book movies we have today. Not to mention, yo, the movie has held up really well. It has John Williams, in my opinion, the greatest composer ever, doing Superman, the movie. It has stood the test of time, still the best Superman movie to date. And it is the best representation of the character. It represents Superman well. It respects what came before. Even if that movie was made in a different time, it's still a better movie, and it's still a movie that filmmakers should look to when they're making a Superman film. They don't have to make it exactly like Christopher Reeve's movies, but this is the Superman that gives you a sense of hope. This is the Superman that you would feel comfortable with protecting you. Unlike the Edward Cullen fucking Superman. Now, let's get to the two best. It's obvious. I know, I don't want to copy him, but I agree with RNG. Probably the most underrated sequel of all time, Batman Returns. I feel like this is probably one of Tim Burton's best movies he's ever made. And not to mention, in my opinion, this is the last good DC movie. There hasn't been a good live-action DC movie since this. I'm not saying that the Nolan films are bad other than The Dark Knight Rises, but they don't feel like Batman movies. They don't really feel like comic book movies. And I feel like Tim Burton, with Batman Returns, embraces the comic book aspects of Batman. And it actually, there was actual moments where there was some humor, but it didn't feel forced. It didn't take itself too seriously. And he actually had some badass moments. And Michael Keaton was great. Yes, I'm a fucking Burtonite, bitches. I'm proud of it. Now, this should be obvious, and I still think this is the best comic book movie. And it's resonated with me well. Batman 89, don't give a fuck. Andre Pedophile Express, go suck it. This is the best Batman movie ever. Jack Nicholson's Joker was great. If there's any Batman, I feel like represented the current age of Batman along with the Golden Age, this did it well. Not only did Michael Keaton, you know, pulled off a believable performance as the Batman, he also did a great Bruce Wayne too, and Jack Nicholson did a great Joker. And I'm sorry, but I am tired of these psycho Nolanites giving this movie shit, claiming it doesn't respect the source material, when it does. I feel like these Nolanites are ungrateful for this movie. This movie brought Batman back to his dark roots. Other than The Dark Knight Returns, this brought Batman back and showed the public Batman wasn't a joke. This is the definitive Batman movie. It still is. It's going to be 30 years old in 2019, and I guarantee you, Batflick will not compare. Those are my top 10 best comic book movies of all time. Now, I'm not going to fucking do this shit in a separate video. I'm doing top 10 worst. And I'm not going to do, I'm do, for dishonorable mentions, well, I'm not going to include The Dark Knight Rises because I don't qualify in the Nolan films really as comic book movies. They're Batman, but more of a realistic interpretation of Batman. So I'm not going to include those. So if you're a Nolanite, one of those who respect other people's opinions, you're not going to hear me trash to talk those movies in this video. Now, I'm going to include some movies that some people would consider anime movies. And before you get to me, before you type your comments, oh, anime movies aren't based on comics. Well, there are some manga-based movies that have been turned into live-action films, and they're complete dog shit. So it should be pretty obvious what's number one. But I'm going to get through number 10, just go through the worst. Number 10, worst comic book movie of all time. This is an easy one. Batman v Superman. As much as I want to put it as probably the top five, there are worse than this. I'm not getting into much detail because I could do a fucking 2-hour rant on this piece of shit. It sucks. Missed opportunities. It's fucking boring. And you have to watch the Ultimate Edition to actually even understand what the hell happened. So yeah, that one sucks. Now, I don't own all these movies, so I'm just letting you know. Ninja Turtles 3. Yeah. What can I say about Ninja Turtles 3? I enjoyed this movie. I know it's shit. I know it's a bad movie. It's a guilty pleasure, but it was a huge step down from the other two movies. The suits were terrible. The villains were awful. And I don't really remember anything that happens in that film, honestly. It was a terrible way to end that series. And not to mention, it contributed to the near death of the Ninja Turtles franchise. So it has to be on the top 9, right? Yeah, so number 9 is Ninja Turtles 3. Number 8, worst comic book movie ever. Batman Forever. This movie is awful, and a lot of people are going to agree with me on this. Some people may talk in the comment section, oh, but there's some good things about Batman Forever. You know, they cut out all the scenes. They cut all this stuff out. There's actual good about it. Okay, first off, where's these scenes? I know they exist. I saw some of them, but they would not have made it into a better movie. It would have not been as good as Batman 89 or Batman Returns. If Batman Forever was released in the way it was intended, maybe it wouldn't get the hate that it gets. But let's be honest. The movie was shit. End of discussion. And until in it, the version of the film that was originally intended gets released in some form, it's still one of the worst comic book movies ever. And it deserves to be on this list because it set Batman back 30 years. And ever since then, DC movies have sucked. And we haven't gotten a real DC movie probably since Batman Returns. That's actually good. So yes, Batman Forever fucking sucks. Number 7. Spider-Man 3. There's a reason why this movie is fucking awful. Not only did we have to wait an additional 3 years for... You had to wait 3 years for the movie. There were so many fucking plot lines going on. It was full of fucking plot holes. Characters act out of character. The character development that the characters got in the previous movies is completely forgotten. In the movie, it was just awful. And I don't even want to talk about Spider-Man 3. It's such a fucking piece of shit. Let's move on. Number 6. Worst comic book movie of all time. Oh my god, it's so awful. Oh, please, need the memories. Fantastic Four, Rise of the Silver Surfer. Oh my god, where can I begin with this fucking garbage? Okay, when I saw it in the theater, I wanted to walk out. It is so awful. It is so fucking boring. The best part of the entire movie, it was shown almost a year before the movie came out. My god. It was terrible, Fantastic Four, Rise of Silver Surfer. There's no reason it's not on one of the worst comic book movies ever made. It fucking sucks. Number 5, worst comic book movies ever made. X-Men 3. Now, why do I put this on here? It's just terrible. But then again, X-Men Origins is even worse. So it's hard to choose between the two. Origins or 3. Both are pretty bad. I would probably ultimately choose Origin. Because Origin is the most forgettable. It is awful. Not even Hugh Jackman's performance as Wolverine redeems that piece of shit. It is so fucking bad. Origins Wolverine is the fucking worst X-Men movie ever. X-Men 3, I would like to put it on here, but it's nowhere near as bad. Number 4, worst comic book movie ever made. Number 4, this is hard. Oh my god, I just have to repress my memories. Catwoman. This movie is so awful that I can't fucking finish this piece of shit. Even though it should technically be higher, it probably would be number 2 worst, which I'm going to put that as... I'm probably going to choose it as number... Whatever, it's his fucking shit, Catwoman. So let's put it at number 3, even though it is awful. I fucking despise that movie. And by the way, I never finished it. It is so fucking bad. Yeah, I think it's number 4. I'm sorry, I lost track. Number 3, worst comic book movie ever made. Batman and Robin. Do I even need to talk about how bad this movie is? How it nearly killed comic book movies? How it set Batman back 30 years, just like Batman Forever? Do I need to talk about the fucking gay-ass fucking outfit? Do I need to talk about the nipples on the fucking suit? Do I need to talk about the shitty villains? How it fucking raped Bane? How it fucking... Oh, I hate that movie so much. And Pedophile Express loves it. Fuck you, Andre. It's the third worst comic book movie ever made. Go fuck yourself. Now, we're getting to the real shitty ones. This is my personal opinion. And I may be biased because I'm a fan. This is the number 2 worst comic book movie ever made. Where could I be getting on this piece of shit? And by the way, I got this used. Okay. At the time it was released, it was 21 years after Ninja Turtles 3 came out. Enough time has passed for people to forget about that garbage, so let's make a better movie than that. Nope. They make a movie that makes that one look like a fucking masterpiece. It's riddled with plot holes. The fucking CGI for the turtles look like shit. Fucking Megan Fox is probably one of the worst actors you could ever fucking cast as April is April. Fucking the Shredder is not even a character. They butcher the origin of the turtles. Oh, fucking A. Shredder? They tried to turn Shredder into a white guy, but they didn't have the balls to stick their guns, so they reshot some scenes, which made it seem like Shredder was Japanese. But in doing that, they created a bunch of fucking plot holes that make no goddamn sense. This fucking movie is awful. I hate this movie so much. And why do I have it on Blu-ray? I got it used. And by the way, I got that one for fucking free when they bought buy two, get one free deal. That's the only reason why I have that piece of fucking shit. Oh, I hate this movie so much. What's the worst comic book movie ever made? Well, it's anyone that's familiar with a certain movie that came out in 2009. It's based off perhaps the most famous manga of all time, which I'm going to call like a comic for simplicity's sake. And it has what's arguably the most popular anime adaptation of all time. You know it, what it is. It's Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball is a franchise that's probably the most popular anime in the world. And one of the highest selling manga of all time. It influenced other manga artists. Its art style, a whole generation of manga artists was influenced by Dragon Ball. Now, how does 20th Century Fox honor such a legendary series, a manga that had such a huge influence on the anime industry? By making the worst comic book movie ever made. Okay, you had shitty movies like Catwoman, Batman Forever, Batman and Robin. Those have some resemblance to the source material. Well, Catwoman is a fucking piece of shit. Ninja Turtles has some resemblance. But why is this the worst? Because it doesn't resemble the source material at all. It has no resemblance to the source material. Everything is completely different than what's established in the manga. Goku isn't interested in fucking girls. Anyone that's fucking read Dragon Ball would fucking know that Goku is interested in fighting. Freaking Yamcha isn't some fucking surfer dude. Fucking Master Roshi is a fucking pervert. And anyone who actually is a Dragon Ball fan fucking knows this. Fucking not a single thing from Dragon Ball is in this movie. None of the creatures, none of the vehicles, nothing. And it has some stupid plot holes. And you would not believe the amount of fucking fanboys this movie has to this day. You have some of the stupidest people defending this piece of shit. And I wouldn't be surprised if Andre Sedino likes this piece of shit of a movie. This movie is so bad, 20th Century Fox was embarrassed to acknowledge that movie fucking exists. As an apology, they helped produce Battle of Gods and Resurrection F. As an apology for making that piece of shit. So, 20th Century Fox, who essentially, a lot of comic book fans view them as raping the X-Men, have no respect for them, really. Yet, when it comes to a manga series, they actually apologized by helped producing two movies of Dragon Ball. Look at this up. Yes, this is my video of the top 10 best and worst comic book movies ever made. And this is just my opinion. If you disagree with me, you're wrong. Especially for Dragon Ball Evolution. It is undeniably the worst comic book movie ever made. No movie is as bad as that. Even though there are worse movies on this list that are technically worse, but we're talking about as comic book movies. It is definitely the worst. Die, Andre, die. You fucking pathetic failed abortion.